Hello student, welcome to my channel. This is Vasant Nayak from Canara Engineering College. Today in this session, we will study one more concept that is called as POS, product of a sum. In the previous session, we have studied SOP. Now, what is the meaning of POS and what do you mean by SOP? We have already studied what is SOP. SOP is nothing but sum of product terms. Now, what is POS? POS POS is a product of sum in any groups of sum terms added together. A product of a sum in any groups of sum terms. Here you can see this is a sum term, this is also sum terms, and finally these sum terms are added together and it gives a product that is called as POS. So, in this here you see we have a function of three variables. In that we got, while simplifying, we got one term which is a sum and one more term which is also a sum, and the product of both these sum terms are called as POS. For example, you can see here we have four variable function and minimal POS for this one is, this is the minimal POS, after solving the equation, after solving the this one expression, we got this one minimal POS. Now, how to write POS, product of sum terms in truth table. So, how to write the product of sum terms, like in we have seen already in SOP the fundamental term is known as a product term. In SOP the fundamental terms is known as a product term and it is represented by min terms. It is called as min terms. But in POS, product of sum, the fundamental term is known as max term. Max term, and it is represented by capital M with the suffix M0, M1, M2, M3, something like that. In SOP, min terms are represented by lowercase m, M0, M1, M2. How to represent this max terms? Suppose you take a truth table of three variable and these are the combination of three variable. To represent a max term, you have to take the variable, you have to write the variable if the variable is value is zero. And you have to write in complemented form if the value of variable is a one. And in between you have to use a sum. That is plus symbol. In between you have to use plus symbol. For example, first one is A plus B plus C, because A is 0, B is 0, C is 0. This is called as M0. Second one is A plus B plus C bar. So in POS, if the variable is 1, then you have to write complement. So here also you can see the variable is 1, you have written complement. So here variable is 1, you have to written complement. Otherwise you can write the variable as it is. Like this you will get max terms M0, M1, M2, M3, M4, M5, M6 and M7 for 3 variable map. For 4 variable, 3 variable truth table. For 4 variable truth table we will get 16 max terms from 0 to 15. Now we will see how to represent this truth table in terms of K-map. So, truth table in terms of K-map, here also we have 1 variable map, 2 variable map, 3 variable map, 4 variable map. So, this is the 1 variable map. Here it is A and A bar, A and A bar, M0, M1, max term 0, max term 1, two variable map. Let me write first two variable map for SOP. You will come to know the difference. Suppose two variable map for SOP. Suppose this is two variable map. If you take two variable map for SOP, then this is A and B, and we have four cells in SOP also for two variable. And but in SOP, so first we will write A bar, and second we will write A. Here also B bar and B. But in case of POS, it is A and A bar, B and B bar, and inside the fundamental, this M0 represent fundamental sum. But in SOP, it represent a fundamental product, A bar, B bar. So A bar, B bar is represented by here A plus B. I told you, if it is here, it is negation. Then in POS, you have to remove the negation, and in between it is product. Here it is in between it is a sum. Similarly, let me take now three variable map. So three variable SOP. So let me draw three variable. So in three variable, I will take A vertically and B and C horizontally. We know three variable, eight cells are there. So eight cells are there. Here it is become A bar. Here it becomes A, and here it is something like this. So here it is a B bar, C bar, and B bar C, and B C bar B C. Now same thing you represent in POS. So A bar in POS, this negation will be removed and this becomes A. And here it is A, this becomes A bar. Now B bar, C bar, B bar, C bar. What you have to do? You have to remove the negation, and in between you have to put a or symbol, B plus C. B bar, C, let me write here, B bar, C, B bar, C, B bar, C. So B bar becomes B, then this product becomes a sum, C becomes a C bar. So you can see a C bar. Similarly, B bar plus C bar, B bar plus C. And inside, now it is A plus B plus C. Here it's inside A bar, B bar, C bar. This is a product. This is sum. Similarly, A plus B plus C bar. Similarly, A plus B bar plus C bar. So this is M, capital M0. This is capital M1. This is capital M2, this is capital M3, max term 3, this is max term 4, this is max term 5, this is max term 6, this is max term 7. Similarly, if you take four variable also, you have to represent like this only. So I have told you about two variable and three variable, four variable also you can try, and this is the K-map for a four variable. Now let's go to now students, in this you can see how the max terms are represented in two variable, three variable and four variable. It is similar to our min term representation, where you represent min terms by using lower case M0, M1, M2. Here it is upper case. And the representation is same, first M0, M1, next, next cell is, this is M2 and this becomes M3, M4, M5, M6, M7. In case of 4 variable, M0, M1, M2, M3, M4, M5, M6, M7, then M8, M9, M10, M11, M12, 13, 14, 15. So we know this representation because we have used this in SOP also. But only thing is here, this symbol changes. Instead of product, you have to use sum, and you have to use negation properly. So this is about the introduction of a POS. Now we will see how to solve a POS problem. Students will see now one problem, how to solve the problem by using a POS technique. So before proceeding, let me once again repeat. Boolean expression problems you can solve by using either Boolean laws or theorems. Second, K-map. In K-map, you have two techniques, SOP and POS, and one more technique is called as EVM method. So we have already discussed SOP. So POS technique we'll see now. So here given function for function of four variables, and if they use this symbol pi m, that indicates you have to solve the problem by using POS method, not SOP method. Please remember this one. So if you see this one, because in the problem they have not mentioned whether it is SOP or POS, by seeing this symbol, you will come to conclusion that you have to solve the problem by using a POS. And M means max terms. Max term means those terms in the truth table which represent zero. Those terms in the truth table whose output is zero is called as max terms. Max terms. So in POS, we will consider the max terms are those terms which output is zero. So in this case, this is max term 0, max term 2, max term 4, max term 10, 11, 14 and 15. Since max term represents 0, you have to put a 0 here. This is M0, 0. Then this is M1, this is M1. This is M2, which is M2? This is capital M2, max term M2. So I have to put 0. Then we have 3 is not there. 3 I will put 1. 1 I will put 1. 4 is there. 4 is there. That means 4 is 0. 5 is not there, 6 is not there, 7 is not there, 8 is not there, 9 is not there, 10 is there, then 11 is there, then 12 is not there, 13 is not there, 14 is there, then 15 is there. And rest of the terms are, you have to put 1. And please remember, in POS, we will make a group of zeros, not group of ones. We will make group of zeros. Now, which group you can make by using zeros here? How many groups you can make? So, let me use a different color now here. So, you can see, I can make a group of zeros like this. One group. Then, I can make one more group, second group, G2. And third group, let me mark by one more color. This is third group, like two zeros. First 4 zeros, second 2 zeros, and one more 2 zeros group I made. First group I will call this group is equal to G1. And what is the answer for this one, G1? So for to write the answer for G1, first see vertically which is common here. A bar is common. So A bar is common here. So write A bar plus then see horizontally which is common. C bar is common. This is the answer. Right. Then what is the answer for this group? This group I will call G2. What is the answer for this group? So what is the common here? Vertically, A is the common. And horizontally, only like one column is there. Horizontally, it is C plus D you have to write. Because only one column. C plus D it is. Similarly, now third group which is marked by circled by yellow line. So which is common horizontally? A plus B. And vertically we have to see this cell and this column and this column. And what is the common here? D. So A plus B plus D. So this is the answer for G3. Now what is the final answer? Final answer you have to write POS expression. So POS expression is product of sum. We got some terms. These are called as sum terms. This. Now answer, final answer is a function of a four variable, that is 4 vary a plus b plus c and d, 4 variable is equal to, we know group 1, let me write group 1 g1 into, like let me mark into by dot, g2 into and g3. So now what is g1? G1 is a bar plus c bar. What is g2? g2 is a plus c plus d. What is g3? g3 is a plus b plus d. And this is called as minimal POS expression. This is called as minimal POS expression. So this is called as minimal POS expression. So this gives you introduction about this video gives you introduction about POS. What is POS? Product like product of sum, and what do you mean by max term, and finally how to solve the POS related problem, etc. Thank you.